Sometimes you need to cut away some geometry to show what's underneath, and that can be a real pain, especially in large scenes with a lot of geometry. Today I'm going to show you how to use the VRay Clipper to cut away the stuff that you don't need. That's coming up. Hello YouTube, I am Kevin the Dane. You guys have voted, and it was almost unanimous, so today we're mastering the VRay Clipper. If any of you guys have tutorial requests, please let me know in the comments below. Now, back in the day, if you had to cut anything, you had to slice it and cap all the holes. A tedious task, especially for large scenes, and depending on your geometry, you might even have to do a lot of manual cleanup. But with the VRay Clipper, the process has become a lot easier, and it is only applied at render time, so your objects stay intact and you thus have a non-destructive workflow. So let's jump into 3D Studio Max and give it a go. So, to create a VRay Clipper, you go to the Create tab, Geometry, select VRay and VRay Clipper. And then you just click somewhere to create the clipper. Now I'm just gonna center this and let's isolate it and have a look. You see here the arrow on the top. This means that anything above the plane gets cut away. So let's exit isolation and let's just turn on angle snapping by pressing A and rotate this 90 degrees around the y-axis. So now we're gonna cut right down the middle and one half of the car should disappear. So let's try to open up the frame buffer and start the interactive rendering. Now you see here that the entire scene is cut in half, including the ground plane, and that's not what we want. So let's exclude the ground plane from the clipper. Click exclude, double click the ground plane, and OK, and the ground reappears. Now we have another issue. The car has been cut, but the cut is this pink color, and that's the wire color of the clipper. We could simply change the VRay Clipper's wire color, but I prefer to use a VRay material instead. So let's apply a material to the clipper, and the cut is now gray instead. If you don't want the entire cut to have one specific color, you can check Use Object Material, and each cut surface will inherit the material from its parent geometry. If you check Set Material ID, you can even use multi-materials to further customize the material on your cut surface. Just set the material ID to 2, for example, and make a multi-material. And for the sake of visibility, I will put a light material in the second slot. And as you can see, the material on the cut surface can easily be customized for each object with only one clipper plane. Let's untick this again. Now you can see here that light is shining through to the inside of the cut geometry, and while this may work fine for this car, it might be an undesired effect in an architectural rendering of a building giving false lighting information. So you can uncheck effect lights, and the light and the shadow will behave as if the object was intact. You can even check camera rays only, and the car will be intact in reflections and refractions as well. To demonstrate this, let's just create a thin box here and give it a glass material and exclude it from the clipper naturally. And as you can see, the car appears intact through the refraction. But let's just revert these changes. Now, per default, the clipper also cuts away light sources. If we uncheck clip light geometry, we can see that the headlights reappear again. This might be useful for architecture as well, where you may cut away lamps in the ceiling, but you still want them to add to the overall lighting of the scene. Now, the final feature here is the mesh mode. This will allow you to use any mesh to cut your geometry, as long as it has a closed volume. Check the box and choose your operation method. Subtractions cut a hole in the shape of your mesh. Intersection does the reverse, it removes everything not inside your chosen mesh. So let's create a torus nut and cut some holes in this car. Choose the clipper again and we will replace the mesh with the clipper since we don't want the mesh in the scene and we want the clipper to align to the mesh that we created. Click pick mesh and pick the mesh. A little side note here, sometimes you need to stop the interactive rendering and restart it to see the final updated result. The same goes when you create a clipper or if you exit isolation while the interactive render is running. And that is it for the VRay Clipper. Remember to throw in a comment below if you are looking for any specific tutorials regarding VRay or 3D Studio Max. And as always, don't forget to like, subscribe, share, tweet, whatever floats your boat, and cut!
Piss! Piss!
Stay intact. For helvete!
But with the VRay Clipper, the